Megs, your personal pharmacist, here today to give you guys some tips on using castor oil for the thinning of hair. So a while back, I kind of noticed that I was having some thinning hair around my eyebrows. So just kind of like at the ends and stuff, I felt like it was getting kind of sparse. And instead of having to fill my eyebrows in with an eyebrow pencil, I thought it would be really nice if I could just use kind of a natural product to apply to my eyebrows to make it grow back naturally. So I really just kind of started searching all over the internet, trying to see what other people have used in a similar situation. And I found that a lot of people were using castor oil. Now, whenever I look at a certain product and I'm debating if I want to use it or not, I always like to go to the primary research studies and see what people are saying. So I went to my favorite website, it's called PubMed, and I searched castor oil and basically any variation with hair that I could think of. Now, unfortunately, it came back with really just about nothing. It pulled up one systematic review, and the systematic review was looking at different kinds of oils that can be used for scarring alopecia. So they were looking at like jojoba oil, castor oil, rosemary oil, pumpkin seed oil, just a ton of different oils. And when I looked at this systematic review, I found that they actually couldn't find a single study that was a randomized controlled trial of people using castor oil for thinning hair. So at that point, I was like, oh shoot, there's not actually any studies I can, you know, go to decide if I think it's actually gonna work or not. So that's when you kind of have to just look at what the compound looks like and how you think it's gonna work in the body to determine if it's actually gonna be worthwhile or not. So what exactly is castor oil? So castor oil is made from castor seeds, and India is the largest producer in the entire world of castor seeds. So this castor seed oil is actually used in industry quite often for coating surfaces, for textiles. It's also really used a lot in the cosmetics industry because it can be used for lipsticks and also lip balms as an emollient. Now, the reason why it has such good emollient properties is due to the fact that it's really high in ricinoleic acid, which is a fatty acid. So that's kind of why it has that nice emollient property, and that's why it can be used in a lot of things for cosmetics. Now, when you're looking at castor seed oil, you look at the structure of it, and part of the reason why we think it could possibly be good for hair growth and hair loss, hair thinning, anything like that, is because it has some antimicrobial properties, which means it's gonna kind of inhibit the growth of bacteria, but it also has a lot of anti-inflammatory properties, which is really probably the most important when we're looking at hair growth, hair loss, hair thinning. So with the castor seed oil, if it's going to be able to help people with inflammation in their scalp, that can be very beneficial, because if you think about a lot of the types of hair loss that there are, so a lot of hair loss is due to inflammation in the scalp due to, you know, eczema or psoriasis or other inflammatory conditions that damage the hair follicle and then cause the hair loss. So that's how people are thinking that the castor oil could actually possibly benefit any kind of hair thinning that's going on. So how are people actually using this for thinning hair? If you purchase the castor seed oil at the grocery store, you're gonna notice it is super, super thick, very sticky, very tacky, and it kind of just sits on top of your skin. It doesn't really blend in. So in order to overcome this, a lot of people mix the castor seed oil with something like almond oil that's a little bit thinner that will kind of make it so that the castor oil can kind of be rubbed into the skin, absorbed into the scalp. Now, I have a huge, huge word of caution with this. So I did read one study, and it was about people using the castor seed oil in their scalp. And what happens is it can lead to what's called hair felting. So that is when you get a huge clump of hair that just combines all into one huge clump, all stuck together. And there is nothing you can do to fix that other than to cut the hair off. So this is exactly opposite of what we are trying to achieve. We are trying to prevent thinning hair, improve hair growth, stimulate hair growth. We do not want to be cutting hair off. So, word to the wise, I would not put this all over your scalp. Now, I have another reason why I don't think overall this product will actually work and be beneficial. So this is kind of my pearl of advice. This is my important part here. So the big thing I found when I was kind of studying how the castor seed oil works in the body, they found that you can't actually absorb the castor seed oil when you apply it topically. So when you just put it on top of your skin, massage it into your scalp or wherever, it's really actually not being absorbed. So all of these properties that we talked about, so the anti-inflammatory properties that we talked about that could possibly be beneficial with thinning hair, those are not actually even coming into play here because you're not able to absorb the castor seed oil. So all in all, it can cause hair felting, where you have to cut your hair off and it's not absorbed. So honestly, you're not getting any benefit out of applying this castor seed oil to your scalp. All right, so that is my opinion on the castor seed oil for thinning hair. Overall, I really just do not think it works. I think it can be more harmful than beneficial. And I hate having videos where I find that the products never work. So for hair thinning, I wanted to give you guys like a little glimmer of hope. If you guys are looking for something out there that is for hair thinning, the product with the most research that I have seen and most efficacy is honestly still Rogaine. So if you were looking for a product, Rogaine could be an option for you. I'd probably look into that, not the castor seed oil. Please make sure you guys subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And stay tuned next Monday. I'm gonna have another video with more pharmacist advice. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.